Good morning students. So in this class we are going to discuss about that motion of connected bodies. So case one, vertical motion. So let the objects are connected by the strings. So force be applied either vertically or horizontally or an inclined plane. So there should be a tension in the string. So consider the two masses m1 and m2 is connected by an inextensible string. So m1 is greater than m2. So the system have the mass m1 and m2. It is connected with the pass over pulley. So if you release the system, so m1 is greater than m2, so m1 goes downward, then m2 goes upward. So that gravitational force acts on mass m1 is used to lift the mass m2. So both have the same acceleration. So m1 moves downward direction, then m2 moves upward direction with same acceleration. Then there should be a tension in the string from M2 to that pulley, then M1 to, so both have the tension T. Then we need to draw the free body diagram. So consider that mass M1 to M2 as a point mass. So what are the forces acts? So there is a tension in upward direction, then gravitational force downward direction. Then we take that coordinate system XY. Then so we go for the derivation. So for the mass M2 we need to apply the Newton's second law, that force is equal to mass into acceleration. So what are the forces acts on M2? So this is M2. So a tension acts in upward direction, so it's plus J. Then a gravitational force acts downward, so it's plus J minus J, that is plus Y minus Y. So in terms of unit vector, plus j cap minus j cap. So t j cap minus m2 g j cap. Then the mass m2 moves upward direction. It has some acceleration. So m2 a j cap, because that mass m2 moves in upward direction, that is plus y direction. So plus j cap. So equate on both sides, you will get t minus m2 g is equal to m2 a. That is equation number 1. The same for mass M1. So what are the forces acts? So a tension, then a gravitational force. So T J cap, that is upward, then gravitational force acts downward. So minus M1 G J cap. Then so the mass M1 moves downwards. So it is negative direction. So the acceleration is negative. So minus M1 J cap. So again equate on both sides J cap. So T minus M1 G equal to minus M1 A. Just multiply by minus on both sides. So minus of minus plus. So M1G. So here minus T. So minus of minus plus. So it is equal to M1A. That is equation number 2. So just add equation number 1 and 2. You will get T minus M2G plus M1G minus T. So the tension T cancel. Then M1 minus M2. So here G is common, so M1 minus M2 into G. Here A is common, so M1 plus M2 into A. So we need to find the acceleration A. So at what is the acceleration? That mass M2 moves upward, then mass M1 moving downwards. So A is equal to M1 minus M2 divided by M1 plus M2 times G. Then, so if the mass M1 and M2 is equal, so both masses M1 and M2 are equal means, so acceleration is 0 because it is balanced. So it is at rest if mass m1 and m2 is equal. Then so just substitute the value that acceleration a in equation number 1. So t minus m2 g is equal to m2 a. So instead of a, use that m1 minus m2 by m1 plus m2 into g. Then so the minus m2 g goes to the right hand side. So its minus becomes plus. So that m2g here it's common, so m2g into 1 plus m1 minus m2 by m1 plus m2. So that m1 plus m2 it's cross multiply and whole divided by m1 plus m2. So m1 plus m2, m1 minus m2. So plus m2 minus m2 cancel. So m1, so that is 2m1 by m1 plus m2. Then tension T, so just multiply. So you will get tension T is equal to twice M1 M2 by M1 plus M2 G. So that is the tension in the string. So if you know the value of that masses, you can find the tension in the string. then the acceleration A. So acceleration A in upward direction. So if it is in a vector, for mass m1, so mass m1 goes downwards. So if it is a vector, so A vector is equal to, so that thing, then g, if it is for m1, it should be minus j cap, because m1 goes downwards. Then if it is for m2, so m2, what is the acceleration, what is the direction of acceleration? M2 moves upwards, so it's plus j. So again, that m1 minus m2, m1 plus m2, same m1 minus m2, m1 plus m2. So the acceleration of mass m1, that is in upward direction, so the m1, that is in downward direction, so minus j cap. So that direction is represented by the unit vector. So if it is for m2, that is in upward, so upward means plus, downward means minus. So in this class we will discuss so that motion of connected bodies. Here the two masses m1 and m2 connected by the inextensible string passes over a pulley. So here m1 is greater than m2. Then what is the vertical motion? Here the mass m1 lifts the mass m2 using the gravitational force. So what is the tension in the string? So m1 and m2 moves with the same acceleration. It's in move upward then downward. So we find the acceleration. Then if it is for m1 and m2, so m1 is minus j cap, here m2 is plus j cap. Then tension in the string is twice m1 m2 by m1 plus m2 into g. So okay, student.